शारदा रिकॉर्डिंग है। एम आई ऑडिबल सर?
ऑडिबल ऑडिबल स्टार्ट చేయండి అన్న రికార్డింగ్ స్టార్ట్
ओके
చేస్తున్నా ఆల్్రెడీ
ओके ओके। गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स, गुड इवनिंग सर, होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग सेफ एंड साउंड। सो इन दिस टुडे सेशन, मी एंड माय फ्रेंड्स विल प्रोवाइड यू सम इंफॉर्मेशन बेस्ड ऑन फ्यूल सेल्स। ओके, सो बेसिकली व्हाट इज अ फ्यूल सेल? अ फ्यूल सेल इज एन इलेक्ट्रोकेमिकल डिवाइस दैट energy produced from a chemical reaction into an electrical energy. So friends, going to few back years ago, in 15th century, the first scientist who have discovered the existence of hydrogen in 15th century, the scientists were discovering hydrogen. Accidentally, while he was discovering about the presence of water, he have discovered the hydrogen. Then coming to late 18th century, a British scientist named Henry Cavendish, he discovered and he constructed that how a fuel cell, he just constructed that a fuel cell. Then coming to human chemistry father, who is Antony Lavoisier, he termed the name as hydrogen. Basically, in earlier days, it used to call as flammable air, because nobody no scientist knew that the air which used to flame, which used to catch fire easily, is known as hydrogen. So Antony Lavoisier named hydrogen, yes. And scientists started thinking that what can be done with hydrogen, as hydrogen was abundant at earth crust and was lightweight and highly reactive. So the scientists started thinking how to use hydrogen as a source of energy. And finally, in 1839, William Robert Grove had an idea of reversing electrolysis of water to create electricity. And he constructed first fuel cell was constructed by William Robert Grove. Yes, more specifically, it is an electrochemical device that combines hydrogen and oxygen to produce electricity with water and heat as its byproduct. See this, friends. The first fuel cell was constructed in 1839 by British physicist and who is a lawyer, Sir William Robert Drew. For many years, little was done to develop fuel cells for commercial purposes. Yes, till now we use fuel cells as commercial purposes, and recent advanced technologies and electrochemistry have made the scientists successful to introduce the fuel cell, which are more efficient than the thermal source of electrical energy. So coming to components, the components and their anode cathode, the property will be told by one of my friend Tarun Patra.
Thank you, Rajesh. Good morning, good evening, guys. I would like to tell about the components of the fuel cell. In the fuel cell, there are about 7 components, like the anode, a cathode, electrolyte, catalyst, fuel, and oxidants. Now we are gonna know about anode. Anode is the negative post of the fuel cell. We can know that we all know anode is minus sign, so it is also called as the negative post. It conducts the electrons that are freed from the hydrogen molecule so that they can be used in external unit. If we conduct the molecules from the electrons, the passing of current is known as the flow of electrons. Using the anode, we can pass the current, and this is going to happen. This channel disperses hydrogen over the surface of catalyst. Now about cathode. Cathode is a negative post of the cathode is the positive force of the fuel cell. This channel distributes oxygen to the surface of the catalyst, conducts electron back from the circuit to the catalyst, and recombines with the hydrogen ions and the oxygen to form water. There is also another component named electrolyte. In this electrolyte, the electrolyte just acts like proton exchange membrane. It is specially treated material which only conducts positive charges ions. And this electrolyte proton exchange membrane blocks all the electrons which is coming from anode. Catalysts. special material that facilitates reaction of oxygen and hydrogen. Usually platinum powder, very thinly coated into carbon or cloth, is called catalyst. It is rough and porous, maximizes the surface area and exposes to hydrogen and oxygen. So the platinum coated side of the catalyst faces the PEM. Now my friend B. Tarun is going to tell about the working of the fuel cell.
Thank you, Bhatro. Good evening, sir, and all my dear friends. Myself, Tarun Kumar. I'm going to talk about the working of H2O2 fuel cells and the types of fuel cells. It will take only 5 to 10 minutes of yours. Okay, let's move to our topic. Pressurized hydrogen gas, H2, enters cell on anode side. Gas is forced through catalyst by pressure. When H2 molecule comes contacts platinum catalyst, it splits into two H plus ions and two electrons. Electrons are conducted through the anode. On the cathode side, oxygen is forced through the catalyst, forms two oxygen atoms, each with a strong negative charge. Negative charge attracts the two H plus ions through the membrane, combine with an oxygen atom and two electrons from the external circuit to form a water molecule. Now I'm going to explain these points from next page. If you look at this figure carefully, you will see hydrogen is supplied at anode and oxygen supplied at cathode. Here you can see the reaction taking place at anode and cathode. Anode accompanies oxidation and its water with the loss of electrons which are accepted in the cathode, resulting to the formation of hydroxyline, that is reduction of oxygen. As you all know, oxidation means loss of electrons and reduction means gain of electrons. So the net reaction is the reaction between hydrogen and oxygen, which produces water, and we all know water is non-toxic. So the byproduct is nothing here, only one product, that is water. Rajiv, turn to the next page. Now I'm going to explain the types of fuel cells. Here we are having alkaline fuel cells, solid oxide fuel cells, phosphoric acid fuel cells, proton exchange membrane fuel cell, molten carbonate fuel cell. I turn to the next page. Here the first one is alkaline fuel cell. It operates on compressed hydrogen and oxygen. Its efficiency is about 70%. And operating temperature is between 50 to 100 degrees Celsius. It's mainly used in Apollo spacecraft to provide both electricity and drinking water. They require pure hydrogen fuel, however, and have platinum electrode catalyst. Turn to the next slide. And another is solid oxide fuel cells. Uses a hard cremic compound of metal oxides and electrolytes. Efficiency is about 60%. Operating temperatures are 1000 degrees Celsius, so no reformer is required for extracting hydrogen from fuel. That is all I wanted to say about. Now my friend will give you explanation about advantages and disadvantages and applications. Thank you. Hello, Rajiv.
PC, sir.
Am I audible, Tarun?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So, friends, coming to efficiency, in this world, whatever the machines that work or the vehicle, everything has a efficiency, which means everything has some capability. Everything has some, which we call as expiry date. Okay, so efficiency, there's the efficiency of a fuel cell too. Efficiency. What does efficiency means? Efficiency means the ability of a cell to convert chemical energy of a fuel oxidation reaction into an electrical energy is expressed in terms of efficiency of the cell. So efficiency, it is defined, the formula of efficiency is efficiency is equal to delta F by delta H into 100, where delta F is the change in Gibbs energy, whereas delta H is the change in enthalpy, okay? So coming to efficiency of the H2NO2 fuel cell, so the Gibbs energy, which is minus 273.2 kilojoules per mole inverse, and the change in enthalpy is minus 258.9 kilojoules per mole inverse. And therefore you can see the enthalpy in H2O2 fuel cell, it gives us the efficiency of total 83%. So we have seen the efficiency of the fuel cell is greater than 50%, which is really good. Now coming to the advantages of the fuel cell, why do we need to use the fuel cell, H2O2 fuel cell, right? So advantages, H2O2 fuel cell gives us clean energy source and it is high efficiency, which is 83%. It gives us more efficiency. It releases no pollution, no harmful pollution and no noise pollution. It is noise reduction. It is more reliable and it is a flexible technology. Coming to clean energy sources, guys, why it is called as clean energy sources? Because in H2O2 fuel cells, the byproduct which we get is heat and water, which is liquid water. Hence, we get a clean energy sources. We don't get any pollution like CO2, which is a byproduct. So coming to disadvantages, there are a lot of disadvantages in fuel cells also, because they are more expensive and the catalyst which we use are platinum catalyst. So platinum is more expensive. And disadvantages, it is the durability. Yeah, fuel cells are not much durable, and safety hazards associated to hydrogen. Hydrogen is also, we have to, there are many hazards while taking the tests, and hydrogen is not readily available. Yes, hydrogen, we cannot find hydrogen everywhere, because we need to first we need to collect the hydrogen, which is not readily available here and there. So coming to the applications where we can use the fuel cells, the H2O2 fuel cells, these are the different places where we can use the H2O2 fuel cells. First, there is stationary, in various transportations we can use H2O2 fuel cells, in consumer electronics, providing power for base stations or cell cities, and while preserving of the food, small heating appliances and notebook computers and hybrid vehicles. Friends, do you know these days, a lot of countries using in hybrid vehicles? Yeah, actually in the first person to invent a fuel electric cell vehicle was Carl Kurz, an Australian scientist. He was the first person to invent a fuel cell electric vehicle. So this was the end of the session. Thank you, friends, for your valuable time. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Rajiv and Tarun and Tarun Kumar Patra. And it's a very nice presentation regarding of the fuel cell. It's very informative and very effective. Thank you.